do you innovate? What is innovation? You know, how do you tell someone, I want you to innovate? It's very easy to say, you know what, we have an organization view that we will innovate, simplify, X, Y, Z in the year. But how does that person know how to innovate? You know, and then someone will come and say, oh, innovation is disruption. Right. So you move from innovation to disruption. So now there's this new word called disrupt, right? So he doesn't know what is disruption. And I think that is where the question comes in to say, are we imparting that knowledge and skill to the person to understand what we want from an organization standpoint? As I look at it, it is about ability to predict the future. It is about ability to see 5 years down the line what products we will be selling as an organization, what platforms we will be using, and what people capacity we will be needing. I think that for me is innovation disruption, and that is a skill that we need in the organizations today, across all levels. You know, Mr. Siddiqui talked about electric cars, he talked about stuff that's going to change the world. I come from an insurance background. When I see cars and I see auto driving cars, I look at it and say, this is something that is going to disrupt general insurance. You wouldn't, so when you, today you insure a driver, when you have a car which is not driven by a man, who do you insure? Do you insure the vehicle? Do you insure the passenger? Or, you know, who do you insure? With the safety measures coming in, who do you insure? You know, who's thinking about that? And I think that is the skill that, you know, we need to teach people. The ability to predict the future today. You know, we all talked about jobs. There are lots of IT people I see in the profile. 5 years back, no one talked about data scientist as a job. Today, I think that's one of the highest, most required jobs and skill set. But did the organizations predict that 5 years back to say we would need data scientists? You know, that's where the whole point comes in as to, is it our ability? We can all go back to the academy and say, you are not doing this or you are not doing that. And, you know, we can have a list of expectations from the academy. But I think as professionals, it is our responsibility to be able to share with the academy what is that we see in the future and we want them to develop today. That's one thing that I wanted to bring in. The second thing is, you know, if you look at all of that we talk, we want people to be creative, we want people to think differently. But when we look at the academic curriculum that we have, it is so boxed that we are actually stifling creativity, innovation, disruption, whatever you may say. You are a science graduate, this is your path. You are an arts graduate, this is your path. Creativity only comes when you mix all of that. When you give people ability to, you know, to challenge themselves. And I'll give you a real life example. I was talking to my son who's 13 years old, saying what would he want to do in life. And he said, you know what, actually I'm very ill-equipped to make this decision. So I said, why do you say that? He said, I have no clue what psychology is. I have no clue what economics is. I am in 8th standard. By the time I reach 10th, I wouldn't have read subjects. And he gave me many more names. He said, and then you want me to make a choice to say what I should major in. Right. So he said, I don't think I'm equipped to take this call. But he also said, I wouldn't want you to take that call for me because that's the new generation. And then he said, why can I not choose my subjects that I want to do? Why is it that if I take science, I have to take physics, chemistry, and bio? If I don't like physics, why can't I take bio and maths and chemistry and economics and psychology and make my own set of what I want to study?